the Japanese teenager to begin this third match. Guy McCree and former European champion Jill Parker still with you in the commentary box here at the Halmstad Arena. We have a chance to catch our breath because the nature of these matches following thick and fast straight on after that second match between Kim Song-hee and Kasumi Ishikawa. Got to get back to business here, though everyone has. As we're into match three, Japanese two up. Mentally here, I guess it's extremely difficult for Yang. Quality opponent she's up against, but also the match situation now. Hammer blow that really for the Koreans to lose that second match with Kim having had three match points herself.
Now with Japan 2-0 up.
Hirano's shown good ability as well. This we talk about the fact they haven't lost a match. Jill, Hirano's been flawless as well, generally, in these positions at sealing the deal, if you like. Very, very good finisher.
Yeah, I mean, she's all the matches she's played. She's played and won five games, and she's won 3-0 every time. But it's interesting, these two players have played each other four times before. In 2015 at the German Open, Yang Ha-young won, but 2017 at the Asian Championships and the Korean Open, and 2018 Asian Cup, Hirano's won all those games. So
as you'd expect, I suggest, overall for the head-to-head to have gone that way, but it's still interesting to note all of that. Hirano's been, for me, watched bits and pieces. I mean, you've probably had a look, even greater look at the Japanese so far this week, but the most impressive of the three, I think, overall level of performance. It's not to knock Ito or Ishikawa, but Hirano's been stunning every time I've seen her.
Yeah, I mean, she's only a young player, 18. I mean, she's won the Polish Open 2016. Asian Championship, she won in China there. She was the winner. And the Women's World Cup in Philadelphia, you know, she won that as well. So she's a very strong player for one so young.
Hirano undefeated, as mentioned already, in the competition so far. Five out of five. A couple of surprise defeats for Yang on ranking and everything else in the group stage. Lost to Germany's number three player, to the Thai number one overall. But otherwise, very strong, as we say. And with that win in the head-to-head, that'll give her some heart. Even if she's lost three times in her matches.
I mean, Yang Ha-young hasn't played that many matches in this event, and she beat Nixie Liang from Luxembourg and Yamada from Brazil. And he said she's had two losses, so she's only played four times.
Yes. That was a quick fire backhand trade. I guess it's just, again, we talked about the selection decisions for the combined Korean team. It's just looking at matchups, isn't it? They had a number of options. You were talking about bringing a defender in. That almost paid off, I mean, in having Kim in there in the previous match. Again, here, just analysing the opponent. It's likely to be most uncomfortable for them.
Yeah, they'd be discussing that and which was the best type of player to play against Japan. Shuffle serve again. Very heavy backspin. Hirano's been very successful with that service. If you can see the markings of the table tennis ball, that means there's not a lot of spin on it. When you can't see the name that's on it, you know there's a lot of spin.
Controlling this opening game, as you might have expected, Hirano. She's expected to win here, but I come back to it again. I think it's very tough for the combined Korean team losing that second match. To come back into things now, these are human beings at the end of the day. Mentally, very difficult for Yang in this situation. And for Hirano, we talked about how good she's been with Japan two up in a tie. Oh, but Yang there comes out on top. These are some really quick fire exchanges, so close to the table, these two, so much of the time.
Yeah, both these players taking it very early. Very short strokes, backhand and forehand, Yang. Keeping pace to pace with Hirano. That longer serving. Same service action. Just played it slightly longer.
Six game points against Yang here in favour of Hirano. Beautiful change of direction out of nowhere from Miu Hirano. She wins the opening game, 11-4. Closing in on another final appearance here. Still work for Hirano to do. It's been a feature of this combined Korean team, their ability to dig in and battle in this match, even if they don't have much to show for it yet.
Herself there to play that forehand, but left that space open wide on the forehand, and Hirano executing into that position.
The applause you're hearing is match on table two has just finished.
Thank you.
So there'll be even more interest if there wasn't already in our particular focus contest here on table one, as spectators turn their attentions across who are watching the action on two. This match here, which Miu Hirano is taking care of at the moment for Japan. Oh, it's fabulous. It's typical Miu Hirano, really. It's razor sharp and it's lightning quick in its execution. And look again, we focus on the footwork here in Halmstad. Happy feet from Miu Hirano to set it all up. So light on her feet, as the best players are. We were talking a lot, actually, weren't we, Jill, about that. We were watching Liu Xiwen, for example, for China, how quick she is onto it. And, you know, there's similarities you can make there, actually. And a lot of it, as you say, comes, it's not just what's going on up top, if you like. It's the lightness of feet as well and the strength in the lower body. It's everything, really, that comes into producing that quality.
Yeah, they'll do an awful lot of speed work on and off the table. But they've got strong legs. But both these players play very close to the table, so they're able to cut down the angles. As soon as you step back, then the angles open up. So they do like to play very close to the table, just like Liu Xiwen. And you can see there the disguise. Just last minute, she just changes direction with the wrist. She played into the middle and then straight down the line.
Yes, because there was a little move from Yang there, actually, to cover the forehand side. So she was definitely, as you say, duped by the disguise.
Light, 5-2. Five, two.
mentioned Hirano's achievements. You were talking about her success in winning the Women's World Cup event, one of the biggest events in our sport. But also go back to the Seamaster, the Asian Championships of last year, the wins that she got there. Ding Ming, Yu Ling and Chen Meng, all in that same event, back to back.
So that's a class player. Who's beaten class players.
For everything she's done, that's kind of a calling card, I would say. Asian champs there to pull off that trio.
Yeah, excellent.
You can kind of just sit down and go, OK, I've done everything now. There's nowhere to go. Thing is, she's still only 18 years of age. She's got plenty to go into the biggest events in the sport. This is one of them, but you think, we talked about it quite a bit, haven't we? Already the players will be thinking a bit about the next Summer Olympic Games, especially the Japanese team, because of where it's taking place. In Tokyo, that's got to be in the back of the mind the whole time, even when they're playing events such as this one. Ultimate motivation.
And I think what tends to happen, you get extra resources as the home country, so they'll put more into training, probably have more practice partners, go to more competitions, so they'll be up in their game.
Yeah, Hirano. You would think a couple of years' time as well. Be absolutely, I mean, she's already extremely good, but a couple of years more development as well coming. It might be perfect for her, actually, those games when they fall. 20 years of age, of course, at that point, those Tokyo games. I'm looking forward to those already, actually. You've got so many big events to come, but naturally the Olympic Games, Jill, you do think about it, particularly when you've got a host like that as well in Tokyo. You know it's going to be good as well. Get that sense already. They'll do a fantastic job.
Oh, they will. They always do.
Standing Hirano, a couple of points away from a two-game lead.
Oh, picked up that backhand well. That banana flick, and then she stepped in that very wristy action. It was a backhand.
Six game points. Emphatically closes it out there on a second game point opportunity. Miu Hirano puts Japan just a game away now. Just a game required to seal the Japanese passage to the final. They're expected to get there in some senses. I mean, we've been eyeing up the China-Japan repeat. And you certainly wouldn't bet against it at this stage. Hirano again reveling in the role of finisher. This third spot in the team. Yang Haiyun just not able to come up with an answer in this match. Similar, you touched on it right at the outset, just similar styles of play, but the truth is, and you've seen it here, Hirano's just better at doing it.
Yes, she hits the ball earlier and harder. And that immediately puts Yang Haiyun under pressure.
Yang, 6 years older. We've got the timeout coming here. 6 years older, but it's been around quite a while. in the women's team as she's been for the Korean Republic as part of a decade. This is really a last throw of the dice, if you like, I think, from the combined Korean team at this stage to call the timeout early in this third game. Again, the respective coaches of what were the Korean Republic and DPR Korea teams getting involved here. It has been fantastic to have them on the same bench, to have the ambassadors in the crowd. Such a historic day, not just for the sport, for table tennis, but I think for sport globally as well. It's a point I made at the outset, just earlier on in the year, with the Pyeongchang Winter Olympics and political developments as well, of course, the world stage. This is just another part of it as well. A show of solidarity between North and South Korea combining here. Looking at this stage like this first match as a combined team here is going to end in defeat. Very tough task, because it was always likely to be taking on the Japanese women's team, and so it's proven to be. I think they'll look back if they do lose out that second match. They could have got something together. Having lost that, Hirano has pushed Japan further, closer to the victory.
In fact, Hirano, I mean, she's 18, so she's still eligible to play junior events.
It's incredible, isn't it, to think of that? Yeah, I don't think she needs to be spending her time in the juniors, and I frankly think the juniors, the ones in the junior circuit, don't want to be seeing her either.
No, exactly.
But with how good she is, she gives the seniors enough trouble.
She's only just 18, so...
Yeah, turned 18 a few weeks ago, actually, 3 weeks ago, Hirano. Big birthday, isn't it? 18, wherever you are in the world. Oh, that's one of the better moments, and there have been quite a few. Just working with so little there, able to find the angle. Short arm jab in that way, the way she just fired that away out of nowhere.
Well, all her strokes are very compact, very short, very wristy action, wrist and elbow.
It's been the tail, really, for Yang. Falling behind quickly in these games. It's happened here again. Doing enough there, Yang. But tentative, and if it sits in the middle of the table, it's good night and good luck, really, isn't it? Against Miu Hirano, the ability to seize on that slightly shorter ball, punch it away. Hive of activity, Hirano.
Serve up well, nice flick. Short with a little backspin. You can see here that in, using enough wrist.
Of mistakes now from Hirano, and Yang back to parity in this third game. Maybe she's not done just yet. Is it just delaying the inevitable, or is this the start of something for Yang?
Serve well, Yang.
Where's this come from? Has Hirano just allowed her concentration to slip a touch? Everything had been going so smoothly. Change of direction again, isn't it?
Yeah, she played that one nicely too. Wide to the forehand, catching Yang out of position.
Serves to come here then for Yang. Wry smile from Yang as Hirano moves ahead again. Forehand delivers flatter, loaded with pace.
See how she turns so quickly. She played that backhand and then she's round there with that quick footwork.
As we say, so young still, not part of that silver medal winning team 2 years ago. We see Kasumi Ishikawa there. She certainly was, because of course Ai Fukuhara was still part of the team at that point. Japanese team developing in that meantime, these younger players. Hirano is definitely a key part of it now. Having a few more issues in this third game. Won the first two easily, 11-4, 11-5. Here she's actually been behind by a point.
Can you play?
In this third game. Eight. Still ahead now though, still two away.
Serve, anticipating, and stepping in to attack it.
This is very creditable from Yang, but we said that about this combined Korean team throughout, that might have lost the first two matches, they might lose this one and lose the tie overall, but it's not for want of commitment. We have been a credit to this combined team as it is, these players so far. And now, Yang has a game point. Don't you believe it? She's taken it. Muhirano looked like she would close in straight games there. But Yang Haiyun, to her huge credit, comes back into things and wins the third game. So back at 2-1 here. Muhirano on Yang Haiyun. The combined Korean team still in this semi-final at this stage.
Talking about a combined team, well, Yang Haiyun, she played with Zhu Xin in the mixed doubles. Zhu Xin from China, 2015, won the World Table Tennis Championships. In fact, she's a really good doubles player. Plays with Yoon Ji-hee, who won many doubles titles together. And I think Hirano and Ito play well together as
yes.
well.
Yeah, well, it's actually how Ito first kind of came known to us, actually through the doubles in terms of achievements on the ITTF World Tour. Together with Ito, they paired up. Yeah, that's fantastic, because that wasn't a bad... quite deep in the table. She took that pretty much on the half volley.
Fantastic countertop spin there. But she gets such good angles, such cute angles. Makes me like how she stares at her opponent, Hirano. It's absolutely beautifully executed.
I always think it's interesting, though, the Japanese team, because they're so good, but it's the way they go about their work. You know, with that third game, the fact that she's lost that, it's kind of a smiling... ability to deliver on the opponent's done in the nicest possible way.
Yes, exactly, exactly.
There's no kind of malice at all. It's just quality table tennis the whole time, but done with a smile. It would have been maybe just a drop of the smile a little bit from Hirano, the failure to deliver, because she was ahead in that third game as well.
Yeah, she was.
Led by 3-4 points even at one stage, midway through it, and just, I think, just lost a little bit of concentration for a moment. Easy to do, of course. These players, we always say the Japanese players, so dialed in. Take it for granted. But here, I think she's looking to just get back into that zone she had in the first 2.5 games. Very good little block that got the net cord as well there. And the drive.
Next slow spinny one she puts in there, which changes the pace. Steaming full speed ahead now. I think that's what I've noticed the last year or so, how much earlier the women are taking the ball and very wristy action.
Well, you've been touching on that, I know, a few times in commentary this week, Jill. Obviously watch the sport year-round, see a lot of it. Is that just purely the gauntlet laid down by the Chinese team? You talked about Liu Xu Wen, but all of them do it a little bit. Is it just a response to that the other teams have had to, the top players have had to respond to that?
Yes, I think so. I mean, obviously the China bring out these different things that they do. And, you know, the other countries follow. But I have noticed a big increase in the players taking the ball really early, but playing hard as well. And that, you know, that margin for error when you're hitting it at that speed and spin.
It's fractions, isn't it? also talked about the footwork as well. I mean, the Chinese are the leaders, and the other teams responding. You just see again the lightness. That's the big thing for me, the lightness of touch really on the floor. So light on their feet, these top players. Something you can't always pick up on the television. You certainly do when you're in the arena. Here in a similar sort of position to where she was in the third game. Yang made the fight back. And this time, though, Hirano will be out to make no mistake. She's normally so good at killing off an opponent, at sealing the deal, if you like.
Yeah, and then you see they played that one into to the middle, the crossover position. Just that change of direction.
Two away now, and looking like she won't be denied this time, Miu Hirano. Looking like Japan will be denied. Runners up 2 years ago in Kuala Lumpur. Looking for another crack at the title here in Halmstad. Fast serve from Yang does the trick. Hirano didn't pick that one up. Deep, fast serve, top spin serve. Drawing the error. Still two away, the Japanese.
Good serve there, but a side spin.
Surely can't happen again.
Oh, you never know.
She wasn't as close to victory, Hirano. It was a lead of... Oh!
That's good play there by Wang Hae-yun.
Well, she's refused to back off. We mentioned how in those trades, those quick-fire trades, Miu is... Hirano's been better, but as it's gone on, it's had a few moments where she's come out on top.
It's interesting that Japan is the only team that hasn't dropped a match in the women's event. So,
I'm keen to keep it that way heading into the final, if they're to get there. And they look like they might do just that now.
Got a hat, make one.
4 match points. Final points for Miu Hirano and the Japan women's team. Japan back in the World Team Table Tennis Championships final. And what a way to do it. Miu Hirano, the ultra-talented teenager, is once again the player to clinch it. 3-0, a historic day for the sport of table tennis with this combined Korean team